Dear viewers and my good listeners, I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to our second episode, Talking Resurrection. Last time, in our first episode, we talked on the difference between resuscitation and resurrection. And I also highlighted some points on the importance of Christ's resurrection to us Christians. And so today, we shall be looking at some historical beliefs that had an influence on this very important and greatest pillar of our Christian faith. We know from history that the Jews and to a large extent all those nations we know in the Middle East were ruled by the Greeks and the Romans. And later, the Jews were under Judaism, their religion. And all these people, or all these functions, had an influence in matters of faith and beliefs to the Jewish people and even the early church. So that's why we need to look at some of these beliefs. Did the Greeks, did the Romans, or how did the Jewish religion view resurrection? And let me start by reading 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 12, which says, "Now, if Christ is proclaimed as raised from the dead, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead?" So Paul was concerned that these Christians of the Corinthian church were to some extent doubting the resurrection of the dead. And so he took it upon himself to explain to them the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ and to show them that there is the resurrection of the dead. So briefly, let me say that according to some beliefs of the Greeks and the Romans, they thought, or the Greeks and the Romans thought, that death was the complete end. Though there are some Greeks also who envisaged a continuing shadowy existence in Hades. Hades is the Greek version of what we read in the Bible, in the Hebrew Bible, Sheol. And again, when we come to the Hebrews, we find in their writings, the Hebrew writings assume that the dead are in Sheol. That is the abode of the souls when they depart or they are separated from this body. And that you can find in Psalm 115 and verse 17. And we know from the scriptures, the Bible, there was this group or sect of the Jewish leaders called the Sadducees who denied future life. And they held a belief that the soul perishes with the body. And we find also in the Bible, especially during the time of Jesus, the Sadducees came with a resurrection question to Jesus. And we can read that in Mark chapter 12 and verse 18. Mark chapter 12 and verse 18. "And Sadducees came to him, who say that there is no resurrection." They didn't believe in the resurrection. But again, we find some Old Testament writings. For example, in Daniel, where we find a resurrection idea. Daniel chapter 12, as well as other historical writings, like 2 Maccabees chapter 7 and chapter 7 and verse 11. There we can find some ideas about resurrection. So we can see that Christianity, when it was born or came to be, it was founded where the central tenet, resurrection, was not either well understood or was thought to be false. And that's why we find even in some letters we find there was not controversy of the resurrection. Now coming to the part of archaeological evidence. This is very limited due to the issue of minimal historical evidence in terms of material. There is very minimal material evidence to show that Christ's resurrection happened. And also, this is affected, or this is due to the destruction of ancient materials. And also, there has been the continuing lack of enough resources to fund excavations. However, there is strong evidence of Jesus' resurrection based on the following 3 points. Number one, the empty tomb, which was discovered by a group of women, as we read in the Gospels. Number two, Jesus' disciples had a real experience. These were people who were living at the time and with whom, and they had interacted very much with Jesus, so they believed and they preached that surely he rose, and their evidence was well recorded. And number three, as a result of the preaching of these disciples, because they preached boldly the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, whatever they preached, it stood, and this led to the establishment of the church which we have today. So the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ is very well founded. There is great evidence supporting this, especially through the church which stands up to now. And on this part, and here I wish to conclude by reading John 11 and verse 25, where Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life, and he that believes in me, though he may or she may die, shall live again." So brothers and sisters, resurrection is there. Resurrection is very true. So those who die in Christ shall live forevermore. Thank you. So next time, or our final part, I shall be leading you in looking at the deeper importance of Jesus' resurrection. So thank you, and God bless you.